So what are closures, where and how we are supposed to use them, where we should not be using them, and where does the concept of accumulators come into picture when we speak of Spark? So hi guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. This is the next session in our Apache Spark series. If you have not seen that video, please click on the I button and watch all previous videos. Now next topic in documentation is understanding closure. So closures are actually a Scala concept, the same language that Apache Spark is based on. So it's important to have a little understanding on what closures are and how we are supposed to use them and how we are not supposed to use them. So when any function that we are writing in Spark, please understand this closely, any function in Spark that we are writing and we are modifying any particular variable that is not in the scope of that function, that can be considered as a closure. So here a small demo they have given. Let me zoom it. If you see, they have initialized a var. Here they have taken it as var because they might be considering it as a counter and it might need to change its value. So we have a var counter. They have an RDD, and on that RDD, they are doing a for each on each and every element and incrementing the counter with the value of x, basically the value in that RDD. So it sounds straightforward. Before explaining this, let us execute this piece of code right away and see, are we getting the output as straightforward as this code looks to be, and jump cut to the boilerplate code. Now what we have to do here is same way, let's define a counter with a var and initialize it to zero. Now let's create an RDD. RDD can be a val because we are not going to change anything in RDD, but use the value of that RDD to increment our counter. So it can be val. Let's have it an array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a simple one. And to create RDD, nothing to explain here. Val pair RDD, sc.parallelize data. Now what are they doing here? On that RDD, for each element, they are incrementing a counter. Let's copy, it's not RDD, we have pair RDD. So each element, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, counter is 0. It should ideally add all the elements because the initialized value is 0. So we should get the sum of 1 to 5. So let's print the value of this counter value, counter, and let's run it. So we got our output. Let me expand this. If you see here, we are getting the value 12. So what do you think? Is our sum... it's 5, 4, 9, 3, 12, 2, 1, 15. It should be 15 and we are getting 12. So do you think Spark is that dumb to add 5 numbers that it's giving sum as 12? Apparently Spark is not, but we are, if in such cases we are using closures. Let's go one step back and understand what went wrong here with this small demo. What happens is we initiated our Spark context or the driver code and initialized our counter as 0 and created an RDD out of that and tried to execute our program. When a Spark program executes, what happens as we all know is the driver submits the programs to worker nodes. Let's suppose we have 3 or more worker nodes which have their individual executors. Counter 0 here is part of the closure and we have created an RDD. How RDD will be saved? The RDD elements that we saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be distributed among the worker nodes by the driver program, correct? And each of that element we are using to increment the counter that was there in driver program. But Spark anyways has to handle this. So what Spark will do, Spark will submit a serialized copy of the counter whose initial value is 0. That value it will serialize and send it to each of the executor to use that in their particular task. We have asked to increment the value of counter. But for the distributed data, if we are using closures, what will happen? The task or the computation is happening on the worker nodes. So in case we are performing any operation, like in this scenario, we are doing an addition, all the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, be it on whatever executor task, but they will just play with the counter values that they have as a serialized copy. So let's suppose 1 and 2 went to executor 1, 2 went to executor 2, and 4 and 5 went to executor 3. Now what will happen in this case is, 1 and 2 will be added to this counter and 2 will be added to this copy of the counter and 4 and 5, that is let's say 9, they will be added to this third counter copy that is serialized. So in this case, if we try to take the value of counter where we are using the println or collect, that is on our driver program. So in this case, we will still have the counter value 0. If you are surprised that we still got 12, as we are running this Spark in local mode, it is not sure that on which JVM the driver and worker are distributed. Every time the Spark application initiates, there are chances that some of the executors will be running on the same JVM. In that case, the value for that particular executor will update the actual value, but not for the other JVMs. And this distribution will be random. Let me show you an example. I'll not do anything in this program. I'll just run it again. You can see, right? The value changed. Now it is giving 15. Apparently it is correct, but that is now how we should be handling a distributed data. Let me run it again. See, now I'm getting 14. So this is very important that when you are handling distributed data, try to avoid closures. Now in place of that, as now you understand the scenario, this is the point that if I explain the significance of accumulators, it will be very clear for you that how and when to use the accumulators. Right now we saw we have to accumulate the data distributed into different worker and executor. So for such cases, Spark provides us concept of accumulator. But as usual, again, let's go back to the official documentation. So this is the function of Spark context, long accumulator, or they also provide the double accumulator as per your use. Sorry guys, I got a glitch in my other laptop. It got stuck when I started Spark along with the screen recording. So I had to come back to this. Anyways, for explaining accumulator, I'll use the Spark UI so that it will be better for you to understand that how this accumulator will work in Spark under the hood. So for creating an accumulator, we have to use Spark context long or double accumulator function. So let's straight away copy from here to save time, and I'll run this from Spark shell as we want to hit it on Spark UI, and I haven't configured my IntelliJ yet. The same, but let's do this from Spark UI. So we have to take a val, any name, and use long accumulator, and here you can name your accumulator. I mean, this is the variable, and the name of the accumulator you can mention in the double quotes. So let's name it as count. So this will be our accumulator. And same way, we have to parallelize an array. As in our closure example, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same way, let's define here. Let's have a 5 also. And use a for each function on this. So let me do that again. Dot for each. And in the previous example, we were doing x such that counter plus x. But here to add these values to accumulator, you have to use dot add function of the accumulator. So the name of the accumulator dot add, and what we have to add to this, the x itself. Got completed. And what got into this accumulator, I mean the value, to see that you can use the accumulator variable name dot value, and this gives us 15, and this will always give us 15 because this is an accumulator. But for better understanding, let's see the same thing in Spark UI. So our Spark UI will be running on the localhost port 4040. So this was our application. Let's go to this, click on this. So here you can see the state of that accumulator application. You can see the accumulators what we defined. The name was counter and it has value 15 as we saw in the console. But how that value grew up to 14, you can see the details of the task. Let me zoom. The operation went into 8 tasks, 0 through 7. And the task 1 contributed value 1 to the counter accumulator. That means the value 1 that we defined, that might be residing in the worker node where task 1 was executed. If you get that, then task 3, it contributed 2. Task 4 contributed 3. And task 7 contributed 5, and so on. So these particular worker nodes which were handling the task 1, 3, 4, 6 and 7. These were actually handling the data which was there in our RDD that we defined here. And total collective value went to the accumulator counter. So this was how accumulator used to work. So guys, I hope I was able to explain you what is the significance of closure, what is the significance of accumulator, what you should avoid, and in which scenario what you should use. So if you like this video, please hit that like button. If you have any questions, please post them in the comment section below. And please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. See you guys in the next session of Apache Spark series.